The Lies of the Third Temple, Part 50. We can't believe it, Part 50. I'm Professor Hannes Redlinghuis of the Third Assembly of Yafashua in South Africa, Pretoria, Montana, also international. Should you require any of the books which I've written, or just have a question, or maybe you need a restoration of the original Sacred 9 Bible, which I have, please contact us at our WhatsApp, which is South Africa International Code plus 27. The number is 0722-367-124, or just go to my website, https://yahvah.co.za. If this is the first time that you are participating in the study, you are very, very welcome, but I urge you to go to part one and start from the beginning. But of course, you have missed quite a bit of the study already. It's also important to subscribe to the channel in order to receive all the different notifications of the different studies that we are busy with. Share this link with your friends and your family. You need to have a 1611 King James Bible, a pen and a writing pad ready. Welcome to Breakfast with Prof Hannes. I trust that this study is going to be a blessing unto you in the wonderful name of Yafashua. We are going to continue reading where we left off yesterday morning. Matthew 24 verse 38. It says, now, as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage until the day that Noah entered into the ark. And they knew not until the flood came and took them all away. And they knew not, they knew, what didn't they knew? Because Noah was preaching, they need to repent because the earth is going to drown. But you see, the people wouldn't believe Noah when he talks about drowning and the water that will come from heaven and flood the earth, because they never seen rain. They knew dew and they knew mist that comes from the sea. And knew not until the flood came and took them all away. So shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. So this scripture says that in the time of Noah, when the rain came, people died. And the earth was flooded and it took all the people away. So also shall the coming of the Son of Man be. Tell me, when Yafashua is coming, the coming, the word coming, the coming, the parousia. In the parousia, when he comes for the bride, will the whole of the earth be demolished? Is the battle of Armageddon going to happen? Is the stars going to fall from heaven? Is the sun going to darken and the moon not give his light? No. He's coming for the bride. The rest of the people will carry on in what they're doing. They're not even going to see him. They will just see suddenly that we are gone. We've been changed from an earthly into a heavenly body, been caught up in the air. We will be meeting Yafashua in the air. We will go with him into eternity, into heaven. Verse 39, and knew not until the flood came. The flood surprised him and took them all away, because they didn't understand. They would not listen to Noah. They think he was half crazy when he preached that they need to come to repentance. They need to change their lives. Their sins is going to cost them their lives. They wouldn't. So shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Now, suddenly, but when he comes in Revelation 19 verse 11 to 21, when he comes to one third of Israel, he's going to put his foot on Mount Olive, and the mount will tear into two parts. That's when he will come on the white horse. He's not going to come and make war with the sword. The sword of judgment is in his mouth. That's seconds before the battle of Armageddon will happen. And that's why it says, shall so it also the coming of the Son of Man be. because they would not believe him. The 144,000 evangelists from the 12 tribes of Jacob will be preaching the gospel of salvation unto the nation of Israel. But two-thirds of Israel will reject him. That's why you must go and study the revelation of the book Revelation from part 1. We're walking through the whole book of Revelation, verse after verse after verse. And I don't need to explain to you anything about what the church says. I show you what the word says, and you can accept it or you can reject it. But you will never ever tell Yahweh, I did not know. So what will happen? In that 7 years and 105 days, listen to what I'm saying. The great tribulation is not for 7 years. 7 years and 105 days. I want to make you curious enough so you can go and study the revelation of the book Revelation. So in that time, the gospel of salvation will be preached unto Israel, because the bride is in heaven. By this time, the whole earth has taken the mark of the Antichrist, the microchip implant on their right hand and forehead. Revelation 13 verse 16 to 18. Because without the mark of the Antichrist on their right hand and forehead, they cannot buy and sell. That's what Revelation says. Also shall it be the coming of the Son. So when he's coming in the Harpachu, the rapture. The rapture is for Israel, one third. The rest of Israel will not believe him. Only the remnant, one third, the elect. And knew not until the flood came and took them all away. So this has got nothing to do with us in this 21st century. And also shall, well, let me say, in 2024. And so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Now listen what will happen when he shall come like a thief in the night. Don't forget the thief in the night. When he comes like a thief in the night, for Israel, you have two petitions, two portions. You have the one third, you have the two thirds. This one third of Israel is not going to be surprised. As we as the bride knows, because we're in heaven already, at the end of Revelation 3:22, we've been drawn away at the coming of Yahushua, the Parousia. But when he's coming with a rapture for Israel, the one third, they are not going to be surprised, because they know when he will be coming. Because Revelation is explained to us how he shall be. Even the time has been given. Daniel 12 verse 11 and Daniel 12 verse 12 together. I want to make you curious. You must want to study the word, especially the book of Revelation. For ages we were told it's a book that is sealed. We're not to look into the book of Revelation. It will make you crazy. It will drive you out of your mind. You will be coming Bible punch happy. Like a boxer that's been hit on the head all the time. You will just sit and you will go crazy because, or stupid because, too much Bible. You can't. Never, never, never. The book of Revelation is not sealed. Go read Revelation 22, verse 10. The angel asked Yahweh, must I seal it? He says, no, don't seal it. The time is near. The certain portions of Daniel, the book of Daniel is sealed, but not the book of Revelation. So what happens is that he's not going to surprise. He couldn't surprise the bride like a thief in the night, because we knew when our bridegroom is coming. Now he will be coming as the bridegroom for Jacob's bride. We've got two portions of brides. I just want to mention it here. One half of it is the Gentile bride. It's us who will be saved by grace. The other part of Israel are saved by the preaching of the 144,000 evangelists. That's called Jacob's bride. And together we will be the bride, the wife of the Lamb. The Lamb's bride, his wife. Go read Revelation 21, verse 3 or verse 4. He says, we are the bride, the wife of the Lamb. Hallelujah. The two together. So he says, now he's explaining, then shall be two, or let me just read verse 39. And knew not until the flood came, that's Noah, and took them all away. So shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Remember Yahweh speaking to these Hebrew disciples. Verse 40. Then shall two be in the field. The one shall be taken and the other one be left. This is not when he's coming for the bride, the parousia. This is in the great tribulation. Actually, I think it's not written correctly. It should have said, then shall there be three in the field. One shall be taken and two shall be left, because it's one third who's the remnant that will be, which will be drawn away when he comes, Revelation 19 verse 11, on the white horse. And with him is coming the bride, all on white horses. So it's not written correctly. Then shall be two in the field, the one shall be taken and the other shall be left. Like I said, I would have prepared if it says, prefer if it says, there were three, one shall be taken, two shall be left. Two women shall be grinding at the mill, the one shall be taken and the other one left. Again there, three women should be grinding at the mill, one shall be taken, the other two, because there's one third, the other two thirds. Watch therefore, for you know not, now listen what he says. Watch therefore, for you know not what hour Yahushua dot come. What does he say? Watch therefore, for you know not what hour Yahushua doth come. But I thought we know. I thought, then that's why I studied with you 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. He's coming for the ungodly, the lost, like a thief in the night. We as the bride, we know the hour, the day, and the minute. Watch therefore, Matthew 24:42, for you know not what hour the Yahushua cometh, doth come. Your Savior will come. Why? Because to them it will be a surprise. To the bride, it is no surprise. We are in heaven already. Verse 43. But know this, that if the good man of the house had known in what watch the thief would come, he would have watched and would not have suffered his house to be broken up. Does that make sense? Of course. So the majority of the Israelites in the Great Tribulation hasn't got a clue when he's going to come. But the one third of Israel who accept him as their Messiah, Savior and Redeemer, they will be expecting Yahushua to come for them. And this is why he says here, but know this, that if the good man of the house had known in what watch, that's the time of the hour, the thief would come. He would have gone out and go to town or do something else at night. He would have watched, stayed at home and make sure if he breaks in that he'll be getting a hiding. He'll be caught. Therefore, Matthew 24, now Yahushua speaking to his disciples. Therefore, be ye also ready. Not a bride. You're Jews, you're Israelites, you're Hebrew people. Therefore, be you also ready. For in much as an hour as you think, not the Son of Man cometh. If you have not accepted Yahushua as your Redeemer and Savior, that is Israel in the Great Tribulation, he's going to come on you like a thief in the night. But otherwise, you will know the time that he will be coming. And that's why you will be, like in verse 33, like the household, the man of the house. You will be the good man. You'll be waiting for the thief to come, not to surprise you. If you knew the hour, you wouldn't have gone out. And that is what verse 34 says, 44 says, therefore be ye also ready, for in much as an hour as you think not the Son of Man cometh. That's not for the bride. But this has been preached unto the church for 600 years. For 600 years, more than 600 years, as Protestants and Charismats, they were preaching unto us, teaching us a lie from the Bible, that Jesus will come like a thief in the night, because we do not know the hour that man he will come, cometh for us. It's a lie. It's a lie. It's a dogma lie created by churches to suit their theology. And so sorrowful that so many people never studied their own Bible. They've been led by their noses, by the pastors and the reverends and the priests. And that's why Yahweh says, go away, I know you not. He says, my flock, my sheep, they know my voice. They know my voice. And that's why it's so important in this studies, this Breakfast with Prof Hannes studies. It's short paths for every day to strive on, to live on, to feed on. And it must urge you to study the Word. Make your own study, your own research. Even the things that I teach and preach to my students, I even say to my students, go and prove me wrong in the Scripture. And so we need to do it. Now time has caught up with us. It's a wonderful week. We have learned quite a lot. We've learned about the lies that have been taught to us. And go and discuss this with other people, because now you have the Scriptures to prove them wrong. Till Monday, if it's Father's will. Maranatha. Yahshua's coming back again. Hallelujah.